Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video tutorial, I'll show you how easy it is to bind local and remote data to the React spreadsheet component. I will also show you how to bind data to the individual cells in a sheet and change the data source dynamically on button click. First, I open my existing project where all the necessary spreadsheet modules are configured and the basic spreadsheet rendering code written. Notice that the data.js file has local JSON data. Let's look at the local data order details. It has the fields customer name, model, color, payment mode, etc. Using the sheets directive tag, I have mapped the data source to the specific range in a sheet. In addition to that, I have added the columns directive tag and specified the custom width for individual columns using column directive tag. You can refer to my React spreadsheet getting started video to learn more about local JSON data binding, the link for which I've shared in the card above and description below. Let me run this example with local data and show you the output. You can see that the spreadsheet rendered with the local data. To bind remote data to a spreadsheet, I need to access the online data service with the help of the data manager. The Data Manager is a Syncfusion library that acts as a gateway and interacts with both local and remote data sources. In this example, I'm going to use the Web API adapter to bind data. I import the Data Manager and Web API adapter from the Syncfusion EJ2 data package. I create an object for the Data Manager and initialize it. To interact with a remote data service, the data manager requires the following minimum configuration, URL and adapter. I provide the endpoint URL in the data manager with a valid service URL to fetch data. This is the online service, which I'm going to use in my application. Then I need to specify the adapter type. The adapter is responsible for processing the response from the service endpoint and the request to it. Set the adapter with the Web API adapter, as the service URL passed to the data manager is created based on the Web API standards. Then enable the cross-domain property. Now, I replace this local data object with the data manager instance. Looking here, the spreadsheet is rendered with the remote data. Next, I will show you how to bind data to an individual cell in the spreadsheet. I comment out the range directive tag. Then add a rows directive tag to specify a collection of row details. Using the row directive tag, I specify details for a single row. Then I include the cells directive tag to specify a collection of cell details. Using the cell directive tag, I specify data for individual cells. I'll keep this row as the header. Using the value property, I provide the header, category 4, column 1. In the same way, I provide headers for the other columns, planned cost, actual cost, and difference. Again, I add the row directive tag to specify details for the next row. Here I provide the values, food, $7,000, etc. For the last cell, I include formula property to display the difference between planned and actual cost. I add the cell details for the other rows. Checking now, data is bound to each cell in the specified spreadsheet range. And formula is applied on difference column. I can also set styles and formats in a cell. I declare the constant variable bold center of type enum and define the CSS styles. I assign this object to the header cells using the style property. See now, specified styles are applied to the header cells. Let's see how to apply format to the difference column. I declare another variable, currency format of string type. Use the method getFormatFromType and provide the format name currency as an argument. I assign this variable to the format property in the required cells. Check now, currency format is applied to the difference column. I can also provide the sheet name using the name property in sheet directive tag and assign the value monthly budget. Notice the sheet name is changed to monthly budget. Finally, I will show you how to change the data source dynamically with a button click. Here I'm going to bind remote data and on button click reload the spreadsheet with local data. First, I uncomment the ranges directive tag and comment out the rows directives tag. Then I add the ref property in the spreadsheet to get its instance. Then, I declare variable spreadsheet object, use it in ref property. Then, I add the button tag with the ID change button and class name eButton. Then add the content, change data source. I add an onClick event and assign the callback method buttonClick. Inside this method, I assign the local data object to sheet 1 using the spreadsheet instance. Notice here, sheet and range index starts from 0. In the app.css page, add the styles for button. Checking now, when I click the button, the data source has changed. In this video, I have shown you how to bind local and remote data to the Syncfusion React spreadsheet component. I also showed you how to bind cell data and change the data source dynamically. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, giving you a free license key to use our React products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.